The NFL is an ever-changing league, and nothing more represents that than the Chargers starting Phillip Rivers in 2019 and seemingly going from Phillip Rivers to a question mark at the start of the 2020 season, whether it would be Justin Herbert starting in 2020 at the very beginning of the year, or whether it would be Tyrod Taylor, and really how Justin Herbert would do in the 2020 season was a big question mark, and that really relates back to his time at Oregon because some players and some analysts really thought Justin was going to be the next big thing like he was, while others famously said that he would become an NFL draft bust, and that he was only drafted that high because he was 6'6", 235 pounds, and could throw the ball 65 yards in the air. Obviously, a year later, Justin Herbert set an NFL rookie record for passing touchdowns, and looks to be not the future of the league, but a very good quarterback, and without a doubt, the Chargers' next franchise quarterback. So needless to say, things are always changing, and in today's video, we are going to be breaking down 5 players that are going to take the next step in 2021. Now, I don't want to just be obvious and pick players that everyone thinks of when taking the next step in 2021, because we are going to select a few off-the-grid players that maybe not a lot of people know about. But anyways, before we dive into today's video, please like the video and subscribe to the channel, as each only take a second to do, and it would be very much appreciated. Now, let's begin. And the first player that we do think breaks out, or at least has a bigger role in 2021 than they've had in the first 2 years of their career, is former second round pick Mecole Hardman. Now, Mecole Hardman is a player that people know, and a lot of people know Mecole Hardman. Mecole is a one-time Pro Bowler, he is a one-time Super Bowl champ, but obviously that Pro Bowl was not because of his receiving contributions. Now, in 2 years, Mecole has 67 catches for nearly 1,100 yards and 10 touchdowns, all on 103 targets, which is pretty good when you break it down by target and by reception. To have those type of numbers as, at minimum, the number 3 option in that offense certainly isn't bad, but Mecole also does not play all of the snaps, and that is pretty obvious when you have players like Tyreek Hill, Travis Kelce, and previously Sammy Watkins. But when you break down Mecole's numbers, they are pretty good, and the Chiefs did invest a second round pick in Mecole Hardman, and I do think he can break out in 2021 and be a pretty solid player. Now, to be clear, I don't think he's going to go from a 41 catch 560 yard stat line to an 85 catch 1200 yard stat line, because that's a little unrealistic in the offense that they're in, as there is only one ball to go around. But I do think Mecole could become a very easily, he could be a 60 catch 800 yard player and have 7 or 8 touchdowns, simply with defenses eluding pressure everywhere, with players like CEH, Tyreek Hill, and Travis Kelce. So in 2021, I do think Mecole Hardman will break out and have a pretty solid year, and without a doubt, the best year of his 3-year career. Next is Panthers edge rusher Brian Burns, who will be entering his third season out of Florida State. And back when Brian was in the draft process in 2019, he was viewed as a very good athlete, and he was viewed as kind of raw, but if he could learn the technique and the defensive end moves that are required to be a legitimate NFL defensive end, then he would prove to be a very good player. And 2 years in, Brian has 16 and a half sacks. He has 37 quarterback hits, which is nothing short of impressive in 2 years. And he has been a very good player for the Panthers, noticeably improving in 2020 versus his rookie season back in 2019. Now, one thing I do want to say about the Panthers and Brian Burns is this team was a team that drafted all defensive players in 2020, and I do think that will soon pay off. They added players like Derek Brown, Yetur Gross-Matos, and most notably, safety Jeremy Chinn. Now, a lot of guys and a lot of Panthers fans will want me to talk about Jeremy Chinn and how he could also apply for today's video in terms of breaking out. And yes, he very much could, but we are going with Brian in today's video, and it would not surprise me, it would actually more surprise me if Brian is not in double-digit sacks for the first of hopefully many times in his career in 2021. I think he has all the tools to become the next great pass rusher. Now, not to say he's going to be Julius Peppers caliber, because that is a first ballot Hall of Fame caliber, but I would be surprised for the next 4 to 5 years if Brian is not at or above 10-plus sacks in every single one of those seasons, and I think it starts in 2021. And next is Packers running back A.J. Dillon, who was a second round pick in the 2020 draft, and the reasoning for this selection, when you break it down, is pretty obvious as to why I think he's going to break out a little more this year. Now, I don't think he's going to be a 1,500 yard 12 touchdown back to be 100% clear, because quite frankly, there's going to be maybe one or two players that do that in the entire NFL this year, much less a second string running back in Green Bay with Aaron Rodgers, the reigning MVP, on the same offense. But the reason why I think he breaks out is look at Jamal Williams' stats over the past 4 years. The lowest amount of a carries he had in a season was 107, which equates to about 6 to 7 per game, and obviously that doesn't sound like a lot at the surface, but when you give a player over 120 touches a year, which is something Jamal had 2 out of the 4 years, and the other year he didn't, he had 119 touches, he had at least 460 yards in every single year. And I do think even with the extension of Aaron Jones, when the Packers see how good AJ Dillon is as a true running back, that especially in those late December games, AJ will receive the ball a lot, as even as good as Aaron Rodgers is, having him throw the ball as much as they did last year probably isn't something they're going to want to do this year, especially if they get up in games and just want to pound the rock and essentially pound the beef behind AJ Dillon, as he is a power back by every definition, and let him run and let him get a lot of carries in the frozen tundra of Lambeau Field. So I do think he will break out, and I do think he will be a solid player. And again, breaking out doesn't necessarily mean Pro Bowl caliber or anything like that, because he will be a running back too. But I do think AJ Dillon at the end of the day will have a much better year statistically than what he had in his rookie season. So the next player is also from the NFC North, and it is Vikings second year corner Cameron Dantzler. Now, as we know, another Vikings corner that would be entering his second year, Jeff Gladney, is no longer on the team, and we will leave it at that. But with Cameron Dantzler, this was a player in his rookie season that obviously, as most corners do in the beginning of their careers, obviously there are few exceptions that we can think of, maybe like a Jalen Ramsey and a Patrick Peterson, most generally struggle at the beginning of their careers because they go from playing in receivers in the Big Ten, and of course there may be a star receiver here and there in the Big Ten, but when you're playing the Purdue's of the world and the Iowa's of the world, and not to disrespect those schools, it is a lot different than going up against a Devontae Adams and Adam Thielen and Allen Robinson every single Sunday. And when you're going up against players like that every single Sunday, you are going to get beat. And but what the good news is that is can be considered as learning pains and growing pains, and Cameron Dantzler certainly experienced a lot of growing pains in 2020. But with the addition of Patrick Peterson, someone he very much looks up to and has been very vocal about how much he looks up to, and of course having another year with veteran safety Harrison Smith in the secondary to guide him and point him out to where he needs to be in certain coverages and formations and schemes, this will only aid in Dantzler's development. And I would personally be very surprised if Dantzler, having said all of this, does not have a very good second year in the NFL. Now, I certainly don't think he's going to become a Jalen Ramsey, you know, put a best receiver on him all game and he'll have 2 catches for 19 yards and he might get burnt for a single touchdown all year. I certainly expect Dantzler to still have growing pains even in year two. But with the guidance of both Patrick Peterson and Harrison Smith, and with the Vikings looking towards to make a playoff push, I certainly expect Dantzler to play good in 2021, and he will be a large part of not only his individual success, but the Vikings team's success and how well their top two corners play in 2021. And the final player that we have for today's video is Antonio Gibson of the football team, who all in all had a pretty solid rookie year as he finished with 795 rushing yards and 11 touchdowns. And one thing to note is he only had 170 carries, which simply does not equate to a lot per game. And he only played in 14 of the 16 games last year. But in the games that he had over 16 carries, the football team won all of those, and he had at minimum 75 yards rushing, and in those games had 5 of his 11 rushing touchdowns. So, not surprisingly, the football team wins a lot when Antonio Gibson also got the football a lot. But what is also worth noting is they did not give up over 16 points in any of those games, so again, not surprisingly, they were more focused on running the football when they had the leads in those games. So that's one thing I do want to reiterate, is it's not just they're handing the ball off to Antonio Gibson and saying, here, go win us the game. It was a combination of him running the football, along with Chase Young in the defense playing good defensive football. So moving forward in 2021, Gibson will certainly look to get the ball more, and understandably so. He only had 170 carries, and for him to have this type of production, also had 36 catches for 247 yards, is very good for a rookie considering what his expectations were heading into the year. He was just a third round pick, and although he was expected to contribute, I don't think anyone expected the type of year he eventually would go on to have. And moving on into 2021, the football team's defense is of course looking to be one of the best in the entire NFL. Their front seven is absolutely lethal, highlighted by players like Chase Young, Montez Sweat, and of course, first-round linebacker Jamin Davis. So I certainly would expect Antonio Gibson to run the football a lot in 2021, given I think the football team will be in a lot of 13-10, 17-14 type games, which would only benefit Antonio Gibson and the amount of times he touches the football. So needless to say, having all combined all of this, I do think he will be in for a good 2021 season. And for fantasy players, I do think Gibson will be very productive as long as he stays healthy. Now, with that being said, that's all I have for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed. And if you did, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. It would mean the world. And until next time, have a great day. Love you guys. Deuces. Peace.